Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. I bought and fixed up a 2007 Pontiac Grand Prix. Now, I'm still editing the footage for the repair of the car itself, but now that it runs and drives great, I feel it's time to start customizing the car. Now first of all, that single DIN Kenwood CD deck has to go. Since I'm selling my Ford Ranger, I'm swapping out its double DIN Kenwood Bluetooth CD deck into this car. Now I can change the display colors to match that Pontiac vibe, but more importantly, this unit has the input wire for steering wheel control interface. I hate nothing more than a car with an aftermarket stereo and dead buttons on the steering wheel. Now, of course, you can buy a black box interface from any number of companies. In fact, I did exactly that with my 07 Chevy Silverado a couple years ago. It works most of the time, and for that vehicle, cost about $60 for the interface for a $99 JVC stereo. I purchased all that at Crutchfield. Some of the buttons, like the phone answer button, they just simply don't work. So here we are a couple years later for the Pontiac I find that might work for my car. I also found a cheaper alternative from Pack Audio that comes with instructions that involve adding resistors and doing math and using a web-based calculator and may or may not work with my car. So I decided that if I have to do all this fiddling around with the wiring and resistors and may or may not work, why not build my own interface? How hard can it be to take an input from one thing and send a corresponding output to something else? So that's exactly what I decided to do. Build my own black box. One thing to point out, the method I'm going to show here today only applies to vehicles that use a resistive divider for the steering wheel buttons. Some cars use the CAN bus, which is basically the car's internal network. And though this certainly can be done, this method is not covered in today's project, but stay tuned for more on that later. So how do you know if your car uses a resistor divider or the CAN bus? The only way to really tell is with a wiring diagram. A simple Google search for your car's make, model, and just put the words wiring diagram should get you what you need. And this is what I got. In the near future, I am planning to make an updated version of this project that's more compatible, programmable, CAN bus enabled. But for today, I'm focusing on what I actually built, an interface that works with my particular Pontiac resistor divider buttons and my Kenwood head unit. It should be easily adaptable to other vehicles and head units, and I'll explain all that a little bit later. Most head units simply expect a code through a wire or jack in the back of the unit. That code is exactly what the IR remote would send it. So the interface you have to purchase separately converts the car's button presses into IR codes and sends them along to the stereo. So knowing we have a resistor divider configuration, how do we build this thing? Well, I figure the best candidate for such a simple decoder encoder would be the Arduino Nano. Small, efficient, fast enough for this purpose, and I have a few of them lying around. But there are two other reasons I chose an Arduino platform over an ESP chip, for example. Number one, I don't need Wi-Fi or Bluetooth. It's just a dumb black box that does one thing. But number two, and probably more important, the ADC, or analog to digital converters, are far superior on the Arduino boards. I find the ones on the ESP chips extremely unstable and unpredictable, and I don't want to add an external ADC or use unreliable readings getting false button presses. So onto that wiring diagram. On mine, you can see that it shows those eight buttons as a single resistive divider, shown as left side and right side. The whole thing is fed to the stereo via the dark blue and purple wires. It does not, however, show the resistor values, so that's where the multimeter comes in. Our first step is to measure the resistance across those two wires for each button press. It's best to press a little hard to try and get the lowest resistance possible, then mark these readings down for each button, or, you know, film it. I redrew the schematic to make it a little bit easier to follow. You'll note that the volume and seek buttons are rocker style buttons, so I drew it that way, but functionally it's still the same as being two separate buttons. I decided to connect the purple wire to the Arduino's A6 pin along with a 1K resistor to ground. Now, to power the Arduino, I use a small buck regulator set to 7.5 volts. For the input of that buck regulator, I tap off the so-called retained accessory power, so that the device runs whenever the stereo runs. You could use a linear 5-volt regulator, but it will dissipate more heat. Your car provides anywhere from 12 to 15 volts, so a linear regulator would dissipate more waste heat than the whole Arduino circuit is using. I chose 7.5 volts as I like a little bit of headroom to allow the internal 5-volt regulator of the Arduino to provide a consistent 5 volts, which we will feed directly into the dark blue wire. So the voltage I should expect on that purple wire with that 1K resistor to ground should be 0 volts when no buttons are pushed, obviously, and about 0.34 volts from the very last button in the chain all the way up to 2.2 volts for the very first button. I figured this all out mathematically using Ohm's law, but that's what I should get. Each button is going through one less resistor than the previous button, resulting in a higher and a higher voltage on that divider network. So to gain the best possible resolution in the Arduino's ADC, I set an external AREF, or analog reference voltage. So internally to the Arduino, there is a 32k ohm resistor on the AREF pin. So if I feed 3.3 volts from the Arduino's internal regulator to the AREF pin through a 10k ohm resistor, I should get just over 2.5 volts as a voltage reference. It's handy that those two pins happen to be right next to each other. So now that I'm using almost the full range of the ADC, measuring from 0 to about 2.2 volts with a 2.5 volt reference, it's time to test this in the car. So I'm running a simple loop on the Arduino that prints out the result of an analog read on pin A6, which I chose arbitrarily. Use whichever analog pin you like. The number being read on that pin will be between 0 and 1023. 10-bit resolution. The results were almost exactly what I had hoped. Each of the 8 buttons gives us a number, each about 100 steps apart from the next, and the highest reading is just about 900, which tracks exactly with my estimated 2.2 volts being compared to a 2.5 volt reference. Don't you just love when math works out like that? So anyway, determining which button is pressed is simply a matter of a few if statements. I store the last 8 samples, each 10 milliseconds apart, and I wait for 8 consecutive samples of the same button. I'm not using an average. I want 8 in a row exact same button. That will give us a pretty high confidence that the correct button is being recognized. The code itself is very well commented and gives a lot more details. And of course, it's linked below, and it's available at justinnelsonsprojects.com. I've also linked to another Arduino sketch for a super simple breadboard project that lets you capture IR codes. Using that, you should be able to plug in your own codes into the interface sketch. Again, details of that are on the website and the description. So we're halfway there. We can reliably detect each of the 8 buttons. How do we tell the stereo what we want it to do? After much research, I came across a write-up by someone named Michael B., which I will link below. This gave me the details I needed, along with some code, which I modified somewhat, to generate the appropriate signal to send to the Kenwood. Conceivably, this should work with any IR remote-controlled stereo. Now, to help the community, if you do successfully decode another brand or model of head unit and get it working with this project, please post your radio and button codes in the comments below. So connecting the Arduino to the stereo involves a couple resistors and a transistor. This is because the wire going into the stereo is internally connected directly to the IR receiver. So you don't want to apply a voltage to it, and you don't want more than 5 volts feeding back to the Arduino either. I drive the base of the transistor through a 10K resistor off of pin D2, and the collector connects to the stereo through a 1K resistor, and the emitter is simply connected to ground. Now you have to be careful what transistor you select. I learned this the hard way. I first used a standard good old 2N2222, only to realize it's not fast enough for this purpose. So I swapped it out with a 2N3904. And everything works perfectly. Now this thing works. I press buttons, the stereo does what I want it to do. Let's make this permanent. So to wire everything into the car, I use these T-taps. I really like these things. They provide nice insulation even when unplugged, and they're easily disconnected if you need to remove the box or make modifications later. If you sell the car, you can yank this whole thing out. You'll note I was also careful to use the same wire colors coming out of the Arduino box as what I'm tapping into. Black, red, blue and purple in my case. Now, this ensures you don't ever mix them up later on. So the end result, it took a lot of trial and error, some tweaking, but now I have a little black box tucked in with the stereo that almost looks like those ones you can buy, but at a fraction of the price to build. Links to everything I use here, including the actual plastic black project box that I love for little projects like this. Links to all of that are in the description below or on justinnelsonsprojects.com. So make sure to subscribe as I plan to expand this project to be fully programmable. You'll be able to capture buttons from your car as well as capture remote codes. And hopefully I can expand it to also use the CAN bus. Leave any comments right here. Thanks for watching, especially this far into the video. I hope you found this video helpful or at least entertaining. Please give this video a good old thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and maybe that little bell so you don't miss out on any future updates to this project. Until next time, be sure to check out one of my other microcontroller projects on your screen.